वेलकम चिल्ड्रन, और नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज 13 प्रोबेबिलिटी। इन दिस चैप्टर वी शैल डिस्कस द इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कंडीशनल प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ एन इवेंट गिवन दैट अनदर इवेंट हैज अकर्ड, विच इज हेल्पफुल इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग द बेस थ्योरम, विच इज अवर थर्ड एक्सरसाइजेस, मल्टीप्लीकेशन रूल ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी एंड इंडिपेंडेंस ऑफ इवेंट्स। Consider the experiment of tossing 3 fair coins. So the sample space of the experiment are, when we toss 3 coins, the sample space are HHH, HHT, HTH, THH, HTT, THT, TTH and TTT. So the number of sample space are N of S is 8. Let E and F are the two events. So E be the event, at least 2 heads appear. So it may be 2 heads or more than 2 heads. So triple H, HHT, HTH and TH. So N of E is 4. So P of E is N of E by N of S. That is 4 by 8, which is 1 by 2. Again, F is an another event which has already occurred. That is, the first coin shows tail. So the first coin shows tail THH, THT, TTH and triple T. So P of F is 4 by 8, which is 1 by 2. So E intersection F, the common element of both the events. So the common element are THH. So E intersection F is THH. So P of E intersection F, which is equal to 1 by 8. We are given that the first coin shows tails, that is F occurs, with the information of occurrence of F, in which the first coin does not result into a tail should not be considered as while finding the probability of E. So this information reduces our sample space, that is consists of all those outcomes only which are favorable to the occurrence of the event F. So the sample point of F which is favorable to event E, that is the sample point of F which is favorable to event E, is THH. So the probability of E considering F as a sample space, which is equal to 1 by 4. So the elements in F are 1, 2, 3, 4. So the common element in between E and F are THH, which is 1. So the probability of E given that event F has occurred, which is 1 by 4. Probability of the event E is called the conditional probability of E given that F has already occurred and is denoted by P of E by F. So we got P of E by F as 1 by 4. The probability of the event E, which is called the conditional probability of E given that F has already occurred, which is denoted by P of E by F. So P of E by F, which is equal to the number of elementary events favorable to E intersection F, whole divided by the number of elementary events which are favorable to F. P of E by F, which is equal to P of E intersection F by P of F, where P of F is not equal to 0. So finding the conditional probability of the examples, so P of E by F, which is equal to P of E intersection F by P of F. So when tossing 3 coins, we got P of E is half, P of F is half, P of E intersection F, which is equal to 1 by 8. So substituting this, we get 1 by 8 by 1 by 2. So 1 by 8 into 2 by 1, which is 1 by 4. So P of E by F, which is equal to 1 by 4. Conditional probability let E and F be two events associated with the sample space S, then the probability of occurrence of the event E when event F has already occurred, which is called the conditional probability, denoted by P of E by F or P of F by E. So P of E intersection F by P of F, where P of F is not equal to 0, and P of F by E, which is equal to P of E intersection F by P of E, where P of E is not equal to 0. Properties of conditional probability. First, the conditional probability of an event E, given that an event F has already occurred, is always greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, that is P of E by F, which lies between 0 and 1. So second one, if E and F are any two events associated with the sample space S, and G is an event such that P of G is not equal to 0, then P of E union F by G, which is equal to P of E by G plus P of F by G. So union of any two events, which is equal to sum of the two events. Then third one, P of E dash of F, which is equal to 1 minus P of E by F. So fourth one, P of S by F, which is equal to P of F by F, which is equal to 1. So that is P of S by F is P of S intersection F by P of F, which is equal to P of F by P of F, which is equal to 1. So similarly, P of F by F, which is equal to 1. Exercise 13.1, first question. This exercise is based on only conditional probability. So first question, given that E and F are the events such that P of E equal to 0.6, P of F equal to 0.3, and P of E intersection F, which is equal to 0.2, and we have to find P of E by F and P of F by E. So P of E by F, using the conditional probability, P of E intersection F by P of F. So P of E intersection F given as 0.2, and P of F is 0.3. So multiplying numerator and denominator by 10, so we get 2/3. Again, P of F by E, which is a conditional probability, which is equal to P of E intersection F by P of E. So P of E intersection F is 0.2 and P of E is 0.6. So multiplying denominator and numerator by 10, we get 2/6, which is 1/3. Second question, compute P of A by B. If P of B is 0.5 and P of A intersection B is 0.32, just substituting in the formula P of A by B, which is equal to P of A intersection B by P of B. So it is equal to 0.32 by 0.5. So when we multiply by 100, we get 32/50. So which is equal to, cancelling this using 25 times and 16. So which is equal to 16/25. Third one, if P of A is 0.8 and P of B is 0.5 and P of B by A, which is 0.4, we have to find P of A intersection B. Now we are going to use a multiplication theorem on probability, that is P of E by F, which is equal to P of E intersection F by P of F, then P of F into P of E by F, which is P of E intersection F. Provided P of E is not equal to 0 and P of F is not equal to 0. So if it is given for 3 events, E intersection F, intersection G, then P of E into P of F by E into P of G by E intersection F, P of G by E intersection F. Provided P of E is not equal to 0, E intersection F is not equal to 5. If E and F are mutually exclusive events, then P of E intersection F is 0. Then P of F is not equal to 0. Then we get P of E by F, which is equal to 0. So we have to find P of A intersection B. We know that P of A by B is P of A intersection B by P of B. Yeah, given that P of B by A, so I'm writing this as P of B by A, which is equal to P of A intersection B by P of A. So P of A into P of B by A, which is P of A intersection B. So P of A intersection B, which is equal to P of A into P of B by A. So P of A is 0.8 and P of B by A is 0.4. So 0.8 into 0.4, which is 0.32. So second subdivision, we have to find P of A by B. So P of A by B, which is equal to P of A intersection B by P of B. So P of A intersection B is 0.32 and P of B is 0.5. So which is nothing but 32 by 50, which is 16 by 25. Third solution, we have to find P of A union B. P of A union B is P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So which is equal to P of A is 0.8 plus P of B is 0.5. So 0.8 plus 0.5, which is 1.3, minus P of A intersection B, which is 0.32. So which is equal to 0.98. Fourth one, evaluate P of A union B. If 2 times of P of A, which is equal to P of B, which is equal to 5 by 13, and P of A by B, which is equal to 2 by 5. So it's given that 2 times of P by A, which is equal to 5 by 13, so P of A is 5 by 26. P of B is 5 by 13. So it's given that P of A by B is 2 by 5. So to evaluate P of A union B, we need to find P of A intersection B. So using this conditional probability, P of A by B, which is equal to P of A intersection B by P of B. By multiplication theorem on probability, we have P of A intersection B, which is equal to P of B into P of A by B. So P of A intersection B equal to P of B is 5 by 13, P of A by B is 2 by 5. So 5 and 5 will get cancelled. We have P of A intersection B equal to 2 by 13. Now we have to find P of A union B, which is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So which is equal to 5 by 26 plus 5 by 13 minus 2 by 13. So 5 minus 2, 3 by 13. So which is equal to 5 by 26 plus 3 by 13. LCM is 26, so multiplying by 2. So 5 plus 6, which is 11 by 26. So P of A union B is 11 by 26. Fifth one, P of A equal to 6 by 11, P of B equal to 5 by 11, P of A union B equal to 7 by 11. We have to find P of A intersection B. So P of A intersection B is P of A plus P of B minus P of A union B. So P of A is 6 by 11 plus P of B is 5 by 11, P of A union B is 7 by 11, which is equal to 6 plus 5, 11, 11 minus 7, 4, so 4 by 11. So second subdivision, we have to find P of A by B. So which is equal to P of A intersection B by P of B, which is P of A intersection B is 4 by 11 and P of B is 5 by 11. So cancelling 11, we get 4 by 5. So third subdivision, we have to find P of B by A. So P of A intersection B by P of A, which is equal to P of A intersection B is 4 by 11 and P of A is 6 by 11. So 11 and 11 will get cancelled. We have 4 by 6, which is 2 by 3. So we'll continue the remaining exercise questions in the next video. Thank you, children.